One thing that a real number line is very useful for is talking about when one number is greater than or less than another number. These are what are known as inequalities. So we use this as a greater than symbol to indicate one number is greater than another number. And when it's reversed, we would say that that symbol indicates one number is less than another number. Now here's how this equates with the number line. We would say that P is greater than a number Q if P is to the right of Q on a number line. So you have your larger numbers on the right, and any number to the left of that would be smaller. So if you have 0 here, it doesn't matter where P and Q are. They can be in the negatives, they can be in the positives. One can be in the negative, one can be in the positive. All that's irrelevant. But if you have one number here, and we'll call this Q, and then you have P to the right of it, then that indicates that P is greater than Q. So if you have these really confusing inequalities, it's very simple. All you do is you plot them both on a number line and you just see which one is farther to the right. And so this is helpful for when you have negatives compared with other negatives and positives compared to negatives and so on and so forth. So let's try a couple. We'll do a few here and we'll run through some examples. So let's say we had 7 blank 3. So is 7 greater than 3 or less than 3? Well, obviously we're gonna start easy. 7 is clearly greater than 3. We know that, but how would you show that? How would you explain that to somebody? Well, on a number line, if here's 0 and you have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, here's 7, and here's 1, 2, here's 3. Well, just look on a number line. 7 is farther to the right than 3 is. So again, 7 is greater than 3 because it's farther to the right on the number line. All right, let's try to make the next few a little bit more challenging. How about negative 3 blank 6? Okay, for this one here, we have 0. We have negative 1, 2. Here's negative 3. Here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here's 6. And again, 6 is to the right of negative 3 on a number line. So we would say negative 3 is less than 6, or you can say 6 is greater than negative 3. Doesn't matter how you say it, the inequality would face this way. All right, a couple more. How about 0 blank negative 4? 0 blank negative 4. Here's 0, negative 1, 2, 3. Here's negative 4. Now, 4 is greater than 0, but negative 4 is less than 0 because it's to the left of 0 on a number line. Another way to say that is 0 is greater than negative 4 because it's to the right of negative 4 on a number line. All right, here's where it starts to get really challenging. How about negative 9 blank negative 11? Now, these really give students a hard time because 11 is bigger than 9, but does that mean that negative 11 is larger than negative 9 or less than negative 9? It gets a little confusing when they're both negatives. Very simply, just put them on a number line. Here's 0, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, here's negative 9, here's negative 10, here's negative 11. So once you have these on a number line, it's immediately clear. Negative 9 is greater than negative 11 because it's to the right of negative 11 on the number line. It doesn't matter that they're in the negatives, it's simply to the right, which makes it immediately larger. All right, last one and we'll be done. How about, we'll just choose some crazy decimal, 4.581, and we'll compare this with like pi, you know, or something like that. Well, pi we know is roughly 3.14159, etc. And on a number line, we'd have 0, and here's 1, 2, here's 3, here's 4, here's 5. So pi would be roughly right about here, 3.14, etc. And 4.581, it's tough to give an exact plotting of that point because it's such a specific decimal, but it's roughly between 4 and 5. And now I see it pretty clearly. This point, 4.581, is to the right of pi on a number line. So that means it's greater than pi.